my contention that my pronouncement to dissolve the former board of PRASA was a necessary step to bring the matter to closure, but also to ensure that I restore good governance, corporate governance, ensure stability, and ensure that PRASA continue to provide services to the South African public. I have taken a decision to appoint an interim board that will oversee the affairs of the entity until the appointment of the new board. I wish to once again place on record that we directed the former board to go deeper into the perceived corruption and leave no stone unturned when dealing with this matter, especially in relation to the Auditor General and Public Protection Services Board and others which were brought to their attention. In dealing with this matter, it is prudent that a clear scope of work and program is determined, and that financial and fiscal prudence be exercised at all times. It cannot be that public funds are spent willy-nilly without clear terms, conditions, and scope of work. In ensuring that PRASA delivers on its core mandate, and that such delivery is underpinned by good governance principles, I expressed my concern over the long and protracted investigation by Werksmans attorneys. My concern was that the investigation seemed endless and without a clear scope and a specific end objective. PRASA's main responsibility is to deliver rail and related services in South Africa. This mandate is implemented in consultation and under the guidance of the Minister of Transport. Ladies and gentlemen, we are a constitutional state governed by laws, regulations, and policies. Similarly, I exercise the power bestowed on me to pull all stops in bringing stability and good governance at PRASA.